Have you ever wondered why some offspring don't resemble either of their parents, but rather look like a mix of the two? This is often due to gene interactions called codominance or incomplete dominance. Today we'll review what they are, a couple of examples, and then finish out by writing some definitions for each type of dominance. In some of our previous videos, we used made-up creatures known as dots. Dots can be either large or small and can have a fluffy or a smooth coat. The large and fluffy alleles were dominant over the small and smooth alleles. Therefore, a dot that had one copy of the large allele would be large in size, and one copy of the fluffy allele would mean that it would be fluffy in texture. We call this complete dominance. However, many traits don't follow the rules of Mendelian genetics. Instead, the offspring has its own phenotype rather than matching either of their parents. We call them non-Mendelian traits. There are three types of dominance that you should be familiar with: complete dominance, codominance, and incomplete dominance. It's easiest to compare them if we use coat color as an example. We're going to breed two dots together, a blue dot and a yellow dot, and see what the resulting genotypes and phenotypes for their offspring could be. Assume that the blue parent is contributing only blue alleles and that the yellow parent is contributing only yellow alleles. We'll be using the letter C for coat color, and the exponent will tell us which variety of color we're talking about. If the offspring of these two dots had the genotype CBCB, it's not hard to imagine what color they will be. Since we only have the blue alleles in the genotype, the phenotype in all three cases would be blue. Similarly, if the genotype is CYCY, we have only yellow alleles in the genotype. Because of this, only the yellow alleles will be expressed in the phenotype. But what about hybrid organisms? The genotype for hybrid offspring is going to be CBCY, and this is often where we see really interesting trait combinations pop up. If the coat color showed complete dominance of blue over yellow, the resulting hybrid offspring would be blue. Only the blue allele from the genotype would be expressed in the phenotype. If, however, the coat color followed patterns of codominance, the hybrid phenotype would be both blue and yellow. Traits from both alleles are present together in the phenotype. If dots followed patterns of incomplete dominance, the hybrid offspring would be a blend of the two parental phenotypes. Rather than having a blue phenotype or a yellow phenotype, the offspring would have a green phenotype. In this case, neither of the two alleles is completely dominant. Let's check out a couple of real-life examples of codominance and incomplete dominance. Some animals, such as cows, show a pattern of codominance in their coat coloring. If a red cow is bred with a white cow, hybrid offspring will have both red and white patches on their coats in a pattern known as Roan. Another example of codominance that's found in humans is blood type. Many kinds of flowers show incomplete dominance in terms of their petal color. If a red flower is crossed with a white flower, the resulting offspring will be pink. Tulips, roses, carnations, and snapdragons are common examples of this. Humans can also show incomplete dominance in terms of hair texture. To finish up, we're going to write out a formal definition for each type of dominance. In the case of complete dominance, one allele is dominant and it masks the presence of the other allele. Only one of the alleles is expressed in the phenotype. With codominance, both alleles are dominant and traits from both alleles are expressed in the phenotype. With incomplete dominance, neither allele is dominant. A blend of the two alleles is expressed in the organism's phenotype. All right, that's it for now. If you found this useful, I hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel and checking out some of my other videos. I also post a lot of diagrams and study aids to Instagram. Thanks again for watching, and please remember to like, comment, and subscribe.